Your challenges mean nothing to the gods, Spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island to the east.
Why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. At first we were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually, I lost that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come, boy. We have a statue to destroy.
My father's grave lies on an island to the east. Do not mistake my mother's statue of Thor with that monstrous eyesore to the south.
That spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Would his story be a reminder? The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
One more for the collection.
water drop, new breaches were exposed. We should search them for resources.
I wonder if the World Serpent even knows part of his body. So, what happened with the hare and the tortoise?
The hare is too confident of victory and foolish, while the tortoise is steady and disciplined. The tortoise wins.
You haven't told a lot of stories, have you? Want to try another story? It can't be any worse than the last one.
Very well. There was a horse. The horse sought vengeance upon his enemy, a stag. But he could not kill the stag alone. The horse met a man, a hunter, and made a deal. He took the man's bit and bridle and allowed him to ride in the saddle on his back. Oh, we will finish that.
Okay. have a language center. We should look for more like this.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Kavikia. You're dead?
You're very perceptive and reckless. Take caution when lighting these braziers. Sather and Hellwalkers will swarm to the flames like moths. I assume we have you to thank for freeing us from a watery grave.
Us?
Other spirits. The Lake of Nine is full of them. Most are able to move on from this realm. But we, lucky few, are stuck here in Midgard. Until our affairs are in order. Perhaps you can help them as well.
We have no desire to help you, Spirit.
Ah, but you already have. I only wished to see the sky again. Farewell.
Disappear.
Come, let us not be distracted.
So, what happened when the horseman had dealt with the hunter?
He took the man's bit and bridle and allowed him to ride in a saddle on his back. Together, they killed the stag, and the horse tasted victory. But the hunter would not release the horse and made a slave of him.
So getting revenge cost him his freedom. Hope it was worth it.
It was not.
Another brazier.
I suppose you wish to light it.
Can I? Kavikia.
Nightmare! Oh my god!
I don't believe it. Are you both alive?
Hello.
I can't remember the last time I saw something walk these islands that wasn't dead or corrupted.
What do you mean?
The desolation, child. It plagues this land, growing more severe with each passing winter.
Do you know its cause?
Not for certain, but I suspect the appearance of the World Serpent, along with the great flood that followed. Many were drowned, myself among them. The dead began to walk not long after.
Do you need anything from us?
Boy.
I only wish to speak to someone again. A wish you have just granted. Thank you.
Did I tell you about offering help?
Don't.
Correct.
But can't we
this
just...
is not a debate. You must learn focus. Our journey need be your only concern.
But what if they can help us? That one seemed to know a little about the lake.
And how does that help us with our goal?
We won't know unless we ask. Well?
Well, what?
The brazier?
If you must. Boy.
Sir. Kavekia.
Yeah! Well done, boys. Never thought I'd see a scrap like that again.
What do you want?
To thank you. These dead Reavers drowned me many winters ago, and I've been itching to see them get theirs.
So you died after all the flooding?
Indeed. I came to the Lake of Nine to pillage Tyr's temple, but I underestimated the severity of the desolation.
Have you seen other men? Living? A bearded one, with tattoos.
Only the one standing in front of me. Thank you both for avenging my death.
Useless.
Well, we can't expect them all to know something useful. Maybe the next one will have more information.
Keep your expectations low, boy. Spirits are rarely useful.
How do they even exist?
When you sever a man from his life, it is not always a clean cut.
So you've met other spirits?
Yes. Many.
What were they like?
Annoying.
Got any more short and purposeful stories from it?
Very well. There was a tale of a frog. His pond had dried up, so the frog and his son left to find a new home. They found a well. The son saw the water and made to jump in, but the father stopped him. He saw the well was deep, and once inside, they would not be able to escape if the water dried up again. Wisely, they moved on.
That's it?
Oh. We will finish that later.
Okay. Ah, more of those. Good.
Ugh!
It's over. It is over, isn't it? So the frog and his son just walked away from the well?
Yes.
That's really not a story. If the son jumped in, it would be a story.
Then he would be trapped and starve while the father watched helplessly.
See? That's a story. On this beach. I think this is the last one. Might as well, right?
Fine.
I'll see what I can fit together. I think we have a complete set of those now.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Kvekia.
Ready up, tough boy.
Almost ready.
Go!
you okay?
I must speak with you.
Another spirit who wants something from us.
What's wrong?
I came to this lake with a group of tradesmen, seeking refuge from the desolation. But how could you know it was even worse at the Lake of Nine?
We cannot undo your mistakes, spirit.
I know that. But I fear for my captain and crew. I believe they are still under the water. Will you find them for me?
Is there anything you can offer us in return?
I have little to offer.
Oh. Well, I'm not sure...
Wait! I died wearing a valuable family heirloom. It's yours, if you promise to find my crew.
Deal.
Thank you.
You are learning.
Why didn't you or Mom ever tell me about the desolation?
I won't speak for your mother, but it was never my concern. Nor should it be yours.
Doesn't it concern us if everything around us is... Done?
Our only concern is reaching the peak.
Really? Then why are we exploring all these islands?
The resources we find improve our equipment. If we stray from the path, it is only to prepare ourselves for the journey ahead.
I can live with that if it means we keep exploring. And helping others.
Another one here.
Look! It's the World Serpent. He's so much bigger than I imagined. Oh, look! He bit Thor! Or will bite him. Looks like. What is that? That smells awful.
Poison.
Oh. What were those things? They smelled awful.
Your mother called them scorn poles. Poison magic. She was the one who showed me how to disable them. What?
It's just funny to think of her teaching you something.
Yes. Mm-hmm.